أفرن. Energy. What is energy?
Light.
Well, that's a type of energy we use all the time. Through outside all day long, we get light from the sun.
Plants can turn sunlight into useful energy, which makes them grow.
Food gives energy to animals and humans so they can live. Almost anything that moves can be used to create energy, enough to run machines and turn on the light. Energy from the sun can generate electricity using solar panels. We can also use wind for motion energy. How about water? We need to drink it every day for our energy. Water's movement in rivers and dams also produces energy. There are so many amazing and creative ways we can create the energy that comes through wires into your home, often from far, far away. Wait, what is energy good for? Television, air conditioning, video games, toasters, showers, computers, washing machines, microwaves, fridges, cars, fireplaces, making paper, and plastic bottles. Well, it's too bad that some people use way, way too much energy. Do you know that we could run out?
Yep, the power could go out. Oops! So what can we do?
Energy. Without it, absolutely nothing would happen. The sun gives us two kinds of energy, light energy and heat energy. At night, electrical energy powers our light bulbs and appliances. There are two kinds of energies, renewable energy and non-renewable energy. Sunshine, wind, water, plants. The flow of energy from these guys never stops. Oil, coal, natural gas, atomic energy. There's a limit to these energies. These energies can be all used up. If we use too much, there'll be none left. So we really should make sure we're not using too much energy, shouldn't we? Does anybody know how we can use energy? The smart way? If you're leaving a room for more than 5 minutes, don't forget, turn the light off. And on a sunny day, why not open the curtains and just use natural light? It's simple. Take out incandescent light bulbs and switch them to compact fluorescent bulbs. These use a lot less energy. Just turn off the TV when you're not watching it. Turn the heating down. If it's cold, wear more clothes. And when it's hot, try using a fan. When you're not using them, why not unplug some machines, like computers, TVs, radios, and video game systems? Something we all need to know, even after charging your phone, your charger will continue to use energy. So unplug it. Water is precious. Energy is needed to clean it. So how about saving a little? Instead of taking a bath, take shorter showers. Try not to keep the water running while you're brushing your teeth. Drippy taps waste a lot of water. Just think, a leaking tap wastes enough water to fill a soda bottle every 30 minutes. Set your washing machine to wash at 30 degrees Celsius. Dry your clothes outside instead of using a tumble dryer. Close the fridge door and never put a hot meal in the fridge. It takes a lot of energy to cool it down. Do you know about Energy Star labels? Well, products with Energy Star labels use much less energy than the others. Keep an eye out for them when you're shopping. And how about riding a bike instead of driving? Being energy smart means doing little things that are important, like using both sides of a piece of paper. And if you can reuse something instead of throwing it away, please do. Want to know something funny? All of these tips won't just help save energy, they'll save you money too.
Renewable energy. In recent years, renewable energy has become very important in the field of engineering. In this day and age, engineers are expected to produce innovative designs that eliminate the use of finite resources such as coal and switch to sustainable energies found on the earth. Due to the negative effects on the environment, we currently face an issue regarding our primary energy consumption. It has become more important than ever to find a replacement for non-renewable energy resources. In a nutshell, renewable energy are sustainable energy sources which could provide for the energy demands for the current generation as well as many generations to come. Due to its replenishing nature, renewable energy could be considered as an infinite source. There are quite a few types of renewable energy, one of which is solar energy. Solar energy is produced as a result of nuclear fusion in the sun. The photons released from this reaction is absorbed by solar panels, which consist of photovoltaic cells. Consequently, electrons are released from the silicon atoms, which are located on the surface of these cells. A photovoltaic cell has two layers of silicon, which have opposite charges. This generates an electric field to convert the chemical energy into electrical energy. Wind energy is also a source of renewable energy. Wind is produced as a result of large convection current in the atmosphere, which is driven by the heat energy of the sun. So as far as the sun doesn't disappear, we should have unlimited access to wind energy. The wind provides kinetic energy for the blades to rotate around the rotor. The rotor is connected to a generator which produces electricity. However, the amount of electricity produced depends on the intensity of wind. Hydroelectricity works in a similar way to wind energy. The gravitational potential energy of the water is transferred to kinetic energy as the water flows through the turbine at the bottom of the dam. Geothermal energy is an emerging form of renewable energy. Thermal energy produced by the earth, where the earth heats up the water which produces steam. Due to the fact that hot air rises, the steam then travels up the tubes and turns the turbines, which then produces electrical energy. Biomass and wave are amongst other renewable energies that has become common during the last few decades. Cost of installation as well as the maintenance is probably the only thing that's holding back renewable energy.
Living systems have been around for a few billion years and will be around for many more. In the living world, there's no landfill. Instead, materials flow. One species' waste is another's food, energy is provided by the sun, things grow, then die, and nutrients return to the soil safely. And it works. Yet as humans, we've adopted a linear approach. We take, we make, and we dispose. A new phone comes out, so we ditch the old one. Our washing machine packs up, so we buy another. Each time we do this, we're eating into a finite supply of resources and often producing toxic waste. It simply can't work long term. So what can? If we accept that the living world's cyclical model works, can we change our way of thinking so that we too operate a circular economy? Let's start with the biological cycle. How can our waste build capital rather than reduce it? By rethinking and redesigning products and components, and the packaging they come in, we can create safe and compostable materials that help grow more stuff. As they say in the movies, no resources have been lost in the making of this material. So what about the washing machines, mobile phones, fridges? We know they don't biodegrade. Here, we're talking about another sort of rethink, a way to cycle valuable metals, polymers, and alloys so they maintain their quality and continue to be useful beyond the shelf life of individual products. What if the goods of today became the resources of tomorrow? It makes commercial sense. Instead of the throw-away and replace culture we've become used to, we'd adopt a return and renew one, where products and components are designed to be disassembled and regenerated. One solution may be to rethink the way we view ownership. What if we never actually owned our technologies? We simply licensed them from the manufacturers. Now, let's put these two cycles together. Imagine if we could design products to come back to their makers, their technical materials being reused and their biological parts increasing agricultural value. And imagine that these products are made and transported using renewable energy. Here we have a model that builds prosperity long term. And the good news is, there are already companies out there who are beginning to adopt this way of working. But the circular economy isn't about one manufacturer changing one product. It's about all the interconnecting companies that form our infrastructure and economy coming together. It's about energy. It's about rethinking the operating system itself. We have a fantastic opportunity to open new perspectives and new horizons. Instead of remaining trapped in the frustrations of the present, with creativity and innovation, we really can rethink and redesign our future.